So, welcome back. I'm Mel and Jay, and welcome to Lincoln Central with your 11th amazing trick tutorial in the Basic Trick series. In this tutorial, we'll be visualizing what the sine ratio is and be doing some simple problems. So what is the sine of an angle? Well, if theta is an angle in a right-angled triangle, we can describe it from the ratio of two sides. The sides are named adjacent, opposite, and hypotenuse, like so. The sine of an angle is simply the ratio of the opposite side to the hypotenuse. Sine theta equals opposite divided by hypotenuse, or put in an abbreviated form, sine theta equals ops over hype. Here is a graph showing how sine theta varies against the angle theta in degrees. You see how the curve is one of decreasing gradient, and for very small angles on the left, the ratio tends towards zero. And looking to the right, for angles approaching 90 degrees, the ratio tends towards 1. Now there are three angles that have important sine values. The angles are 30 degrees, 45 degrees, and 60 degrees. Down the side, these numbers don't look particularly easy to remember, do they? Well, there is a way to actually work them out. Let's look at the 30 degree and 60 degree angles first. These angles reside in a special right-angled triangle of sides 1, root 3, and 2. You can see by using Pythagoras how the numbers work. 1 squared plus root 3 squared equals 2 squared. In other words, 1 plus 3 equals 4. Now to the angles. Sine 30 degrees equals 1 divided by 2, which gives a half, or 0.5. Sine 60 degrees equals root 3 over 2, which is 1.732 divided by 2, or 0.8660. Let's now look at the 45 degree angle. These angles, there are two of them, reside in a special right angle triangle, this time of sides 1, root 2, and 1. You can see by using Pythagoras how the numbers work. 1 squared plus 1 squared equals root 2 squared. In other words, 1 plus 1 equals 2. And so to that 45 degree angle. Sine 45 degrees equals 1 divided by root 2. This gives 1 over 1.4142, which gives 0.7071. So remember these two triangles with sides 1, 2, root 3, and 1, 1, root 2. They are really useful. Now for some problems. Basically, there are three types of problem. For each, I'll work through an example with you. In the first problem type, you are given the angle and the opposite side and required to work out the hypotenuse. So here we go. Example number one. A right angle triangle contains a 46 degree angle with the side opposite measuring 8.2 centimeters. Calculate the length of the hypotenuse. The first thing to do is to analyze the information given by writing it out in one line. Theta equals 46 degrees. Opposite side equals 8.2 centimeters. Hypotenuse equals x centimeters. Answer to two decimal places. I found it always a good thing to visualize the problem by making diagrams. So I've made a little right angle triangle with the side names and a larger triangle with the numbers on it. We are required to find the hypotenuse, so let's label it as the unknown x. To start, we write out the sine ratio equation, putting a 1 under the sine theta. So we have sine theta over 1 equals opposite over hypotenuse. Repeating this, putting in the values for theta and the opposite side, we get sine 46 degrees over 1 equals 8.2 divided by x. Now cross multiply, that's top left by bottom right equals top right by bottom left. This gives x sine 46 degrees equals 8.2. So we have a linear equation with no fractions in it. Now we can easily make the hypotenuse x the subject of the equation by dividing both sides by sine 46 degrees. The sine 46 degrees cancels on the left, leaving the x alone. So we have x equals 8.2 divided by sine 46 degrees, which equals 8.2 divided by 0.7193, which equals 11.3999. Therefore, the hypotenuse x equals 11.40 centimeters, rounded to two decimal places. Now let's look at the second type of problem. Here you're given the angle and the hypotenuse and required to work out the opposite side. So example 2, a right angle triangle contains a 51 degree angle with the hypotenuse measuring 13.9 centimeters. Calculate the length of the opposite side. First our diagrams and information. Theta equals 51 degrees, the hypotenuse equals 13.9 centimeters, the opposite side, let's label it y centimeters, and remind ourselves that the answer is to 2 decimal places. As before, we start by writing out the sine ratio equation, putting a 1 under the sine theta. So we have sine theta of 1 equals opposite over hypotenuse. Repeating this, putting in the values for theta and the hypotenuse, we have sine 51 degrees of 1 equals y over 13.9. Now cross multiplying top left by bottom right equals top right by bottom left, we have y equals 13.9 sine 51 degrees, which equals 13.9 times 0.7771, which equals 10.80169. Therefore, the opposite side, y, equals 10.80 centimeters to 2 decimal places. Now let's look at the third type of problem. Here you are given the opposite side and the hypotenuse and required to work out angle theta. So let's do our third example. A right angle triangle contains an angle theta with its opposite side measuring 12.8 centimeters and the hypotenuse measuring 17.7 centimeters. Calculate the angle theta. Here's our information. Opposite side equals 12.8 centimeters. Hypotenuse equals 17.7 centimeters. And we have to find angle theta to 2 decimal places. First, write out the sine ratio. Sine theta equals opposite over hypotenuse. Repeat this, putting in the values for the opposite side and the hypotenuse. So we have sine theta equals 12.8 divided by 17.7, which equals 0.7232. Punch the sine minus 1 function on your calculator and enter 0.7232. Press the equals sign and theta equals 46.3193 degrees. Therefore, to 2 decimal places, theta equals 46.32 degrees. And that's all, folks. The next tutorial will examine the cosine ratio with more worked examples. Anyway, thank you for watching. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe. You don't want to miss the latest vid. See you soon.